All right, welcome back here to the Weather Center with Sandra. And this morning at 6:44, search and rescue efforts underway after a rapid fire, really deadly tornado sweeping through the Midwest.
Yeah, right now at least 16 people are dead in Arkansas and one dead in Oklahoma. There were also tornadoes in Nebraska, Iowa, and Missouri. And another storm struck Joplin, Missouri. And that's the same place where a massive tornado just in 2011 killed 161 people. So it continues this morning, the threat.
Something like 12 tornadoes in the span of 24 hours. Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be a three-day event with the severe weather risk continuing for the midsection of the country over in through even the Ohio Valley before all is said and done. But take a look at where the line of fire is right now. On our first alert radar, you can see a tornado watch highlighted by the orange extending all the way from Texas in to Tennessee with some severe thunderstorms highlighted by the yellow there embedded in this. Now, we've had some tornado warnings throughout the morning as well. So far, no live reports on the ground of what's happened this morning, but the threat is going to continue all day long today. Sometimes it's just in the overnight hours. No, this very, very warm, humid air mass continues to collide with some very strong upper winds aloft. So the tornado threat today, immense. Heaviest and most dangerous places to be would be in northern Alabama and northern Mississippi. That's highlighted by the bright red here. But the threat extends all the way through St. Louis to Atlanta down into the Gulf Coast. So all the way from the Gulf Coast to the Midwest, bottom line. Here, though, we are actually protected and things look great. Let's take a look outside at our sky cameras. No problems out there right now this morning. Sun is making its way up. It kind of looks like, you know, the pastels of a Monet painting, I like to say, in Delray Beach this morning. So all is well. Temperatures in the upper 70s in South County, upper 60s on the Treasure Coast. It looks to our north that then maybe the sea breeze will develop and there'll be some showers over the Orlando area, but nothing for us today. Things are going to be hot and dry. Forecast high in the upper 80s. Yesterday we hit 89 out at Palm Beach International. That's well above the average of 83. More of the same today with those southeasterly winds. Tonight it looks like mid to low 70s at best, so not a lot of cool down whatsoever. It is going to be quite balmy out there. High pressure is protecting us from that massive storm system, which will continue to move eastward across the U.S. Things look good for area boaters. 2 to 4 foot seas, a light intercoastal chop. The sun is now up, and then the sun sets this evening at 7:50. Your headlines as we progress through the next 7 days and take a sneak peek. A hot and sunny week ahead. More tropical humidity by next the middle part of the week, thanks to more of a south flow directly from the Caribbean. So the cold front will not get through here until over the weekend. It's a weak front at that, so we'll just be a little bit more refreshed as we head through the second half of your weekend. It's a Sunfest week, so by Wednesday, it's just going to be hot. Thursday, hot. Friday, hot. Take a look at these overnight lows in the 70s. So dress appropriately. Slight chance of a shower Thursday through Saturday. But again, it's not too bad. I think the best shot of rain for Sunfest would be on Saturday. Definitely not a washout, so it'll be perfect and ideal for that. Back to you guys.
All right.